Hey there, friends. It's your Bad Couch Guru, Lynn Lemberg, here again. And today I have a special guest, colleague, friend that I met a couple years ago named Kim Peek. And Kim owns the Power of Run, and she just today has a big celebration. She is celebrating the launch of her book that she wrote. And I really thought that this book would have some great information and resources for a lot of us who've been listening for a while to Couch to Active. And so, Kim, first of all, welcome to the Couch to Active podcast.
Thank you. Thanks for having me on. And thanks for helping me celebrate the big day.
Oh my gosh. I am so excited. I got to read the book. I already wrote my little, support for it. It's great. Really great book. So Kim, tell folks just a little bit about what this book is and who it's for.
The book is called Wholistic Endurance Training, The Integrated Approach to Thriving as an Athlete. And it's really about much more than running or triathlon. It's for anybody who wants a more active lifestyle. And my focus with the book really is to help people learn that training is not one size fits all, and encouraging people to take a self-study approach so that they can basically learn how their body reacts to a whole bunch of things that we do, whether that's our exercise, our nutrition, our sleep, any other movement that we have, the stress that's in our life, and respond accordingly once we learn how to be more in tune with the signals that our body is sending.
One thing that really attracted me to this was a lot of times when folks think, oh, I want to train for something, like maybe I'll try a triathlon, maybe I'll try a half marathon. The first thing we do is we Google training plans for triathlon, and it says do this number of miles this day, this number of miles that day. That never really worked for me. And later on down the road, I figured out it partly because I had some health issues I was unaware of. So for somebody who's sitting in that boat, how does this book help them?
Well, I always say that the number one most important part of any training plan is consistency. You have to be able to do this consistently. And consistency doesn't mean you have to get out and run every single day. In fact, I discourage that. Mm-hmm. But consistency means doing the right things for your body, getting enough rest, getting enough recovery, getting enough cross training, strength training, so that you don't get a bunch of injuries that sideline you, for one.
Injury is the fastest path to success. No, injury free is the path.
There you go.
And you teach people how to do that so they can really get their fastest path to success for themselves. Injury free, feeling good, actually enjoying it. And Kim, you've always been like super fit. You've never had any troubles or at all, right? So that's why you wrote this book, is because it's always been easy for you.
I wish I could say that was true. I actually started out and hated running when I started. And I've told that story so many times about how I became a runner. I'll let you read that one in the book or find it somewhere else. But when I first became a runner, I went from hating running to becoming just completely overzealous and found myself overtraining, which led to being chronically injured. So I spent a lot more time on the sidelines than I did training. It was really frustrating. And so then I started seeking out answers. And it was back when we didn't have all this information on the internet like we do now. Mm-hmm, and mm-hmm. You didn't know where to turn. We have a lot more resources now. But I started seeking out answers. I initially went to a training program because I wanted to learn how to help myself. And then once I got there, I was like, oh my gosh, this stuff is mind-blowing. Why isn't anybody teaching this? And that's kind of how I became a coach. But I first wanted to do it to learn how to help myself. And so then from there, I did become stronger. And I've learned just a lot of tips and techniques to help me and the people I coach now become stronger runners. I like to say that I want you to get to the finish line or the start line of the race, happy, healthy, and strong. I think it's really, all of those things are really important. If you're not getting there healthy, then we did something wrong. And so then right as I was at the height of all of my excitement, all of my greatest athletic abilities, and I am by far not an athletic superstar, but I had finally gotten my act together.
No, you're good. Training, yeah, you're good.
Training
yeah.
really well.
Yeah. yeah.
And then I was diagnosed with breast cancer. And that kind of sent my life into another tailspin in terms of, you know, just everything that goes on with your life when we have a cancer diagnosis. But then also, I wasn't able to train at the same level or the same intensity that I was used to. And in the book, I talk about how I kind of went through a couple of years where I was embarrassed to race because I didn't want people judging me. So, you know, I think that's kind of funny in a way that you have somebody who knows all this stuff. And deep down, I know I shouldn't care if somebody's judging me because I do this for myself because I love it. But it took me a couple of years to get where I'm like, last summer, I finally said, I'm going to go race. I'm going to do this. I'm not really going to make a big deal about it. I'm just going to go run, do a triathlon, and I'm going to do it for fun. And the funny thing is, I had so much fun. I just went to this race, had the most fun, did it to the level that I was capable of. And while I was out there having fun, accidentally qualified for triathlon nationals.
No way. I love, oh my gosh, that is such, yeah. such a great story because it is, it's about living a life we love. And if you can take that health, fitness, exercise and flip it on its head, get rid of that mindset that's like, oh, I must be better than everybody else. It's so good for us. It's so healing. So
another one of the things that I talk about in the book, I interviewed a cardiologist who's based in Kansas City named Dr. James O'Keefe. And he's famous for a TED talk called Run for Your Life. And it encourages people just to take a more like 80-20 kind of attitude to their training, 80% easy pace, 20% higher intensity. So more of a polarized approach. But one of the things I really liked about him as I dug into his research was he also has a TED talk called Get Outside and Play. And it's all about the importance of play and how we'll stick with our exercise program if we make it fun and make it playful. And I like that approach to training because I think that means, you know, if you're a triathlete or anybody who's just starting to run, wherever you are, if you can think of it as play and think about how you can make it a social activity and involve your friends and involve your family, you're more likely to stick with it. You're more likely to train at an intensity that is going to keep you from getting hurt. And I think that you also avoid burnout because you're not isolating yourself from your friends and family. If you can find a way to, let's go do yoga or let's all go play pickleball this weekend and that'll be my cross training, you know, just keeping it fun.
I love that approach to life if you can make it fun. So Kim, if folks want to get a copy of your book and learn more about you, where do we send them?
They can get it at any online bookseller. Amazon is probably the most obvious, but any place that you buy books online, you can find the book.
And you are Kim at, your website is?
Crushingmygoals.com.
All right.
Crushingmygoals.com. And if you want to read more about the book, you can go to crushingmygoals.com/book. And on there, there's a video where I talk more about the book. And then if you want to enter your information, and once you buy the book, you can get some bonus materials where I go into some of the things that, you know, you just can't fit everything you want in a book. So I go into some of the things that are in the book in more depth.
All right, friends. So find Kim at crushingmygoals.com/book. Check out her bonus materials, get a copy of her book, and see if it inspires you to do something more than you ever thought you could do. Kim, thank you so much for joining us today. Appreciate it.
Thank you. And thanks for having me here on the big book birthday.
Woohoo! Exercise should not be dreadful, but getting off the couch, we know, is the hardest exercise of all. Did you know that Couch to Active has an app? It's the easiest way to keep track of and follow the Couch to Active podcast. So head on over to your app store, and it doesn't matter whether you're on an iPhone, a tablet,
or an Android device, search for Couch 2 Active, that's T-O Active, download the app, and check it out. Bye-bye now.